The Japanese are tired of bureaucratic delays that also prevented the start of production on the F-35 under license at Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. So the Japanese government is targeting technology once rejected by the U.S. Air Force. We're talking about the project of the YF-35 fighter, which at one time could become a Raptor, but did not. The current fleet of the Japanese Air Force consists of 330 fighters. The most massive combat aircraft remains the F-15J DJ Eagle fighter. There are 189 of them in service. As you probably guessed, we are talking about the McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle fighter of the McDonnell Douglas Corporation, which has already been absorbed by Boeing. The majority of Japanese F-15s were built by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries under license. Further production of the F-15 makes no sense. Airplanes are rapidly aging, so Japan is preoccupied with finding replacements. The process began back in 2010. It was assumed that the United States will provide a license for the production of F-35 at the facilities of Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. But time passes, and Japan still does not build fighters. The U.S. does not give license for the F-35, but offers to sell ready-made aircraft. However, Japan does not want to lose its own technology. Buying aircraft on the side will cause the decline of its own industry. Therefore, the Japanese government is frantically going through options. One of the likely scenarios is the acquisition and revival of the YF-35 fighter project. This is a truly outstanding aircraft. The appearance of the YF-23 in Japan will significantly enhance the country's defenses. Now we will tell you about the YF-23 in as much detail as possible. But first, a little history. So, in 1981, the Pentagon announced a competition to create the world's first fifth-generation fighter. More than $86 billion has been allocated for the ATF, Advanced Tactical Fighter, program. At today's prices, this amount is equal to $240 billion. And in the not-so-distant future, the equivalent is likely to exceed $300 billion. Yes, so far this is the most expensive project in the history of military aviation. The work took several years. By mid-1990, the Northrop McDonnell Douglas team presented the first prototypes of the YF-23, the Black Widow II, and Grey Ghost. However, during testing, the U.S. Air Force abandoned the YF-23 in favor of Lockheed Martin's YF-22 prototypes. This is how the F-22 Raptor appeared. We have already told the story of the competition between the prototypes YF-23 and YF-22. You can easily find this video on our channel, so we will not touch on this nuance in detail. And here and now, we will talk about the outstanding capabilities of the YF-23 fighter. The YF-23 is 67.5 feet long. The wingspan is 43.7 feet, slightly larger than the F-15J DJ Eagle, which is in service with the Japanese Air Force today. However, the YF-23 has a wing area of 288 feet. Note that for F-15J, this figure is 185.35 feet. The difference, as you can see, is huge. The higher the wing area, the higher the lift. To create lift, a three-dimensional integral arrangement is used here, in which the fuselage smoothly passes into the wing. This design helps to obtain high lift values at low speeds. That is, the YF-23 fighter is potentially capable of taking on board more weapons than the F-15J DJ Eagle, or have a larger supply of fuel, which will provide a larger combat radius. However, the range and total takeoff weight of the YF-23 and F-15J DJ Eagle are almost equal. The ceiling is also the same. It is 66,000 feet. And in terms of maximum speed, the YF-23 is even slightly inferior to the old man F-15J. Why don't the better raw numbers make the YF-23 superior in speed, range, and payload? The fact is that the design of the YF-23 has high air resistance, which is not very good for an aircraft. The brutal appearance of the YF-23 is diluted only by the drop-shaped fairing of the single cockpit. This is the only flowing line in the YF-23's guise. The rest of the faces are either parallel or strictly perpendicular to each other. To compensate for the increased drag, the YF-23 creators used a movable cantilever on the leading edge of the wing. Why create a complex airframe with chopped shapes and then compensate for this with additional mechanisms? Everyone knows the main engineering rule: the fewer parts, the more reliable the design. The answer is simple. The specific design of the YF-23 fighter ensures the lowest possible reflective effect of the aircraft. Stealth is the most important characteristic for a fifth-generation fighter. The F-15J fighter does not and cannot have such outstanding stealth properties. In favor of the stealthy airframe, YF-23 can also be attributed to flat engine nozzles, which are located in the upper plane of the airframe. The recessed nozzle design reduces the YF-23's infrared signature during supersonic flight without afterburner. This means that the YF-23 has incomparably greater chances of surviving an attack with homing missiles. This is a proprietary technical solution of the Northrop designers, who at one time created the unsurpassed and invisible B-2 Spirit. So that the surface of the YF-23 airframe adjacent to the nozzles withstand the high temperature of the outgoing jet stream, they were protected with a special protective coating. The same heat sink material is used on space shuttles. No space technology is used on F-15J fighters. A little more about the airframe design. The maximum speed of the F-15J at low altitudes reaches Mach 1.2, and the design of the YF-23 allows you to accelerate at low altitudes up to Mach 1.6. This indicator expands the capabilities and scope of the fighter, and also increases the survival rate of the aircraft. The YF-23 has a thrust-to-weight ratio of 1.36. This is 10-12% more than the F-15J. The thrust is provided by a pair of Pratt & Whitney F-119 engines. The same units are now used on the F-22 Raptor aircraft. General Electric YF-120 engines are an alternative. Anyway, they also participate in prototype tests. However, this version of the power plant did not go into production. Who knows? Maybe the Japanese will decide to revive the General Electric YF-120 engine at the same time. The tail unit of the YF-23 fighter deserves special attention. This is the real cherry on top. Recall that the tail assembly is necessary for stabilizing and balancing the aircraft in the air, and also for controlling the aircraft along two axes: yaw, left-right, and pitch, up-down. Even small nuances in the tail design can drastically affect the characteristics of a fighter. The classic tail scheme is one vertical and two horizontal stabilizers, which are directly connected to the aft fuselage. This is the most widely used design. The tail unit on the YF-23 is two solid swivel panels set at an angle. There are no traditional vertical and horizontal keels that are commonly used on airplanes. The YF-23 swivel tail panels do not stand vertically, but are located at an angle of 45 to 50 degrees from the vertical axis. This solution significantly complicates the control of the aircraft. It is known that the absence of a vertical stabilizer causes dangerous and uncontrolled swinging of the aircraft about the vertical axis. Special skill is required from the pilot. Why did the designers of the YF-23 take this step and complicate the work of the pilot? Now you will understand that this technical solution is not applied by accident. The inclined tail panels of the YF-23 fighter improved the aircraft's radar stealth by reducing the aerodynamic ridge. This is a truly revolutionary solution. No wonder the new Russian Checkmate fighter received a similar design. You can learn more about this plane from another video that you will find on this channel. Well, now it's time to talk about the shortcomings of the YF-23 fighter. Experts say that the biggest and most notable drawback of the YF-23 is the design of the aircraft nozzle. The fact is that most of the newest fighters have moving nozzles. This design allows you to change the thrust vector. An airplane with an adjustable thrust vector gets phenomenal handling. No mechanisms or devices in the wing or tail unit can compensate for the absence of an adjustable nozzle. Russian designers have been particularly successful in this direction. SU fighters are considered the most maneuverable fighters in the world. The air group of highest skill of the Russian Air Force, Russian Knights, uses three types of aircraft: SU-27, SU-30SM, and SU-35S. The show, which is shown by the pilots from Russian Nights, has become the main event of an exhibition of aviation technology for a long time. The skill of the pilots and the high maneuverability of fighters are recognized by absolutely all specialists as a unique phenomenon. Without an adjustable thrust vector, the YF-23 is an easy target for the more agile fighters. Therefore, YF-23 pilots will have to avoid aerial duels at close range and destroy the enemy at a great distance. However, the YF-23 has only four air-to-air missiles: AIM-120, AMRAAM, or Sparrow AIM-7. These are medium-range missiles. Additionally, the fighter is equipped with two short-range AIM-9 Sidewinder missiles. Obviously, this weapon does not solve the problem. This means that the Japanese will have to look for suitable missiles capable of attacking the enemy from a long distance. Also among the shortcomings should be mentioned the lack of a deck version of the YF-23. It is known also that the Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Forces want to re-equip their Izumo-class destroyers helicopter carriers for F-35B short takeoff and vertical landing fighters. Due to the design features and the lack of a controlled thrust vector, YF-23 fighters will never be able to take off and land vertically. How the Japanese military will deal with these shortcomings is still unknown. Note that this is not the first attempt to revive the YF-23 project. In 2004, Northrop Grumman asked the U.S. Air Force to build a bomber based on the YF-23. The project was considered seriously. However, the fighter had insufficient flight range. Bombers must be able to fly further. The YF-23 is now being offered to Japan. Northrop Grumman obviously does not want to part with the idea of reanimating the YF-23. We completely agree with this idea, because the more unique aircraft, the more interesting videos on our channel.